In our last video, we showed you how the parameters service is integrated with Revit. In this video, we'll explore how to create parameters in the parameters service. There are several ways to populate your parameter collection within the parameters service. Only account admins and project admins can create or edit parameters in the service. Account members can only browse parameters in the service and can load them into projects. First, you can manually create your parameters. To do this, log into the parameter service as an admin and select the plus icon. Note, this option is accessible to an admin wherever they launch the service, no matter from where. Here, we are presented with a dialog with all the possible data you can attach to a parameter. To create a parameter, you only need to provide name, data type, and property palette group. The default properties palette group is other. However, the power of the service is that you can set more data for your parameters. Taking a closer look at this dialog, you can specify if a parameter should be of type or instance based. You can add a description for your parameters, and we suggest that you do. You can set if a parameter should be read-only or hidden. Category bindings can also be set for your parameters. Most of these settings are just defaults, making it simpler to add them to Revit without editing. You cannot override name, data type, or the read-only and hidden flags. You can check the option to create another parameter to continue to make parameters one after another. We keep already set data and only clear the name and description. This should make creating multiple similar parameters at once a bit quicker. If you select a parameter by name, you can edit the parameter's description and can update the default values. We'll cover editing parameters in bulk in a later video. Now, if you're wondering if you need to manually recreate all of those parameters again, don't worry. We have a couple options to make working with existing information much easier. You undoubtedly have a shared parameter file or files. If you'd like to just use your existing files, you can select the Upload to Parameter Service button. If you are in the Autodesk Construction Cloud, you will only see the option for the shared parameters file. If you are in Revit, you'll see another option that we'll get to next. Select Browse and navigate to where your shared parameter text file is located. Once selected, hit Upload Parameters. We will process your file and upload all of the parameters in your collection. Once complete, you can download a summary of your upload. If any parameters fail to upload, we will provide a reason for the error. A common error is that a parameter or another with the same unique identifier was already uploaded into the service. Parameters uploaded from your text file will have all of the information from the text file. However, they will still be missing some data, as type versus instance, category binding, and property palette group are set when loaded into Revit. We do add the file name and parameter group from the text file uploaded as labels to your parameters. This should help make it easier to find where a parameter came from and to filter for a specific parameter. We will cover labels in our next video and search and filtering options in a later video. Now, if you already have a Revit project or template that has all of your parameters loaded and configured correctly, we've also provided a shortcut to populating your collection. From Revit, open the project or template you want to use, then launch the service as an admin. Select the Upload to the Parameter Service button and select Active Model and Upload Parameters. The service will pull all of the shared parameters from your file along with all of their settings and upload them into the service. Note, project parameters or parameters previously loaded from the service are excluded from this upload. This process may take a moment as the definitions within your Revit project are updated to be aware of their new service counterparts. Once loaded, you'll see that the property palette group, type versus instance, and category bindings are already set. These parameters are ready to be round-tripped into another Revit project or family immediately. This means you do not need to spend time setting information for your parameters in order for them to have defaults, nor do you need to change any overrides when importing into Revit. This allows you to have a complete parameter collection that matches your company standard in a single upload. The only trade-off when uploading parameters from a Revit project or template is that we do not populate as many labels for you. We add the new from Revit label to any parameter uploaded from a Revit file. As the groupings within a shared parameter file are not carried into the Revit project, we don't have that information to populate those labels automatically. In our next video, we will explore labels within the parameters service and how you can make use of them to quickly find the parameter you need.